ensembles and our wind ensembles. If you want to know a little bit more about this event, you can see it's an annual event combining students from different Mennonite high schools for 2 days of playing and getting to know each other. There's a focus, a strong focus on improving our musical skill and ability. And the weekend, I mean, a lot of what's happening is some really solid teaching and some excellent instruction. We've had that from our guest directors this week, Sean Brubaker and Richard Adams. We also hear about community, about getting to know students from other schools. And that comes through in our break times. We try to get people to mix with each other, and we also pair people up within the orchestra and within the band based somewhat on mixing people from different schools. So community and music, and it's been a wonderful time of both of those. We're going to go ahead and get started with our program. If you have something that makes noise, phone or any other device that dings or whirs or chirps or squawks like a bird or anything like that, please make it silent and enjoy our program.
so that was Russian sailors' dance, and it was supposed to be this Cossack dance that starts very slowly and then just gets totally frantic. So hopefully you were imagining some Russian Cossack dancers. Next, totally change of style, is Somewhere from West Side Story. If you're familiar with that musical that Richard Bernstein wrote the music for, you're aware that it is a 1950s translation of the Romeo and Juliet story from Shakespeare, in which two rival gangs who hate each other in New York City, a young man from one gang and a young woman from the other gang fall in love. And somewhere in the middle of the musical, they sing this song together, that somewhere, someplace, perhaps they could be together. If you listen carefully, the ending of the piece gives you a hint that that's not going to happen. Somewhere by Leonard Bernstein. Next piece is entitled Saliendo, which it translated meaning leaving. And the piece is supposed to evoke this bittersweet feeling that you're leaving something, but you're going to something good, but yet you're leaving behind something also good. I was relating to our seniors, and it'd be something like that. You're leaving home to go off to college, looking forward to that experience, but you will miss your friends and family back home. So this is Saliendo by Susan Day. So the next piece we're going to play is a beautiful arrangement of Amazing Grace that features a violin soloist. So when I was talking to Mr. Stutzman, I said, I'd really like to do this piece. Do you have somebody that can pull this off? And he goes, oh yeah, we've got somebody that can do this. So we're really blessed to have Ada, who's going to play our solo for us, and enjoy Matt Riley's arrangement of Amazing Grace.
Thank you.
portion of the program with a medley of Irish tunes called For the Star of County Down. Before we do that, I would just like to express my thanks to Mr. Stutzman and to these wonderful students from Doc High School and EMHS for allowing me to work with them these past 2 days. It's been a real delight. I mean, every moment, a real delight. So it's been a privilege being here. They've hopefully learned a few things and enjoy playing the music, as you can hear how they're performing it in 2 short days. Even though they feel like long days, it's in a short period of time to put together an orchestra and have a program like this. So parents, friends, you should be really proud of your string program here at EMHS and also at Doc. And disappointed that the Lancaster folks couldn't join us, but maybe some other time I'll get to come back at some point and get to see them too. So here's our final selection for the Star of County Down.
Thank you.
So I wrote a piece. I've known Brian for a long time, Mr. Buchanan. We mostly play country music together. We play both kinds of music, country and western, as they say. And Brian plays guitar. I play saxophone with him sometimes. I play bass with him sometimes, just different things. So we've known each other for a while. So I wanted to write a piece for that band, and that band had about 32 people in it. So I literally went and came up here one day during class and said, just stand in a row. And it had a couple saxophones, had a couple French horns, had this, had a few trumpets. So I wrote it for that band, no other parts. And then I got asked to come back. And I said, well, man, you're going to have 60 people. This is cool. So I had to write some more parts in this. And this is called Simon's Bell. It's named after Menno Simon, the founder of the Mennonite Church. I'm not a Mennonite. I'm a Lutheran, just like the band director, Mr. Sugart from Pennsylvania. I grew up a Lutheran. But we're still Germans and like whoopie pies, okay? So what can we say? Anyway, like fatty food. It's all the same food. That's how I can tell you that. My grandma used to come to Pennsylvania to buy antiques from North Carolina. It's all the same food, and it's good, and it makes
too big like me. Okay. Anyway, so I tried. This is almost like a movie score. I've written some things for video, and it feels more like a movie score. So you can kind of see the pictures. And I thought the bell kept it really simple. So it's a pastoral piece. It's pretty slow. It's not very hard, but it involves a lot of dynamics, a lot of really playing in tune. I wrote it for, you know, not to be a lot of notes. So this is it. And it features, of course, the bell. So here we go. So here. So this is called Simon's Bell. And I almost forgot this the last time. If you return to your program, where it says winds, winds, strings, strings, and it says, Father, we sing to thee, sing to set us free. Father, we bring to thee love and peace and kindness. The other thing I know about Mennonites are, besides having good whoopee pies, is they can sing. Okay, so I decided to take advantage of this, because as soon as this band started singing, I said, y'all sound great. So you get to sing too. So when I come around and go like this, you'll already know the tune because they will have already sung it several times. Thank you. guys, they usually have a really good percussion section in this group, and you got to keep them busy. And these guys, they're nuts, man. I mean, I'm telling you, they were back there dancing today. They were great. I'm a gigging musician, so I'm used to hanging around with people like that anyway. So these guys, so we're going to keep them busy back there doing all their stuff. And it's really quick. It involves a lot of speed. It involves the saxophone, alto saxophone section. Have this part that's really, really hard at the beginning. So it's a good challenge for them. It was a good two-day challenge for them. One of the problems with band, when you have a band, strings, you know, they do this, right? Band people are going for like 2 days. So we have to take a lot of breaks. Where you learn to play games like what?
Rock, paper, scissors.
We did like, we'd stop every once in a while, but we'd have like this little contest going on in the band, so we had to take some breaks. So they lasted well. So this is called Celebrate. Methodist Church, as weird as that sounds, but they'll have a good time. Okay, anyway, the last song we're going to do features a combo. So combo, come on up. Get the combo here. When you're playing New Orleans music, and at a Dixieland funeral, it kind of goes like this. just a closer walk with thee. They'll go down the street marching, and all of a sudden the drummer will go like, you know, after the processional's over with, they'll go, yap-ach, yap-ach, yak-dak-dak-dak, dub-a-dub-a-dub, just. And everybody's happy and kind of having a good time. And the season of Lent is coming upon of us now, and Tuesday is Fat Tuesday, and I'm actually playing that also down at Mill Street Grill in Stanton if you want some good food. And y'all come on over this way. Don't be bashful. You're New Orleans people. Come on, man. They should be asking for tips. Come on, there you go. All right. And this is our kind of New Orleans jazz combo. We worked today. We worked on some real authentic New Orleans jazz sound. They pretty much got it down. All right. Even the guy with the tuba with the strap on. Very perfect. Anyway, and this is called At a Dixie Man Funeral, and it features kind of the band and the combo and the band combo. Once again, thanks for having me out. Thanks for all the people that helped. It's been a great time coming up here. This is a great school. It's always, coming from a public school background, it's always great to come to a private school. You get to meet the kids, you get to hear about where they're going to college, you get to see their manners, you know. It's really a good place, so thanks for having me out. They have good manners. Most of the time.